Monarch Butterfly Nail Mural Part 1 by Hotpinkzebrapolish.
Hi guys, in today's video I'm going to be showing you part 1 of my 2018 mural contest entry. Now this mural contest had to be submitted by, I think it was December 12th or something, and I got married at the end of December and I had no time at all. I did this in like a day and I just kind of, I don't know, rushed it. So I guess I wasn't really overly happy with it, but I decided I'd share it with you guys anyway. It did not place or anything this year, which is fine. I didn't really expect it to, because like I said, it was at a time where I was just, my to-do list was crazy long. So I hope you guys like this anyways. It's all Monarch Butterfly themed with lots and lots of butterflies and lots of milkweed. This part is just going to be the background, so everything that is non-3D, the 3D butterfly will be uploaded tomorrow that goes with this. So check back for that. I will put a link to it in the description box below when that is uploaded. Otherwise, I hope you guys do like this, and don't forget to click subscribe to see all my future videos as well.
So to begin with, I already have the blue, I already have the nails glued together and painted blue with a layer of matte gel top coat on top of it. And so then I'm just going to begin, and this is a time lapse, so this is actually, it's pretty quick. I'm going to start with all of the stems of my milkweed. So I'm pretty much just going to show you guys one half of this because it is fairly symmetrical actually from side to side. I did kind of try to keep it, so it was not symmetrical, but so that it was balanced from side to side. So they're very similar. And so I'm just taking green, like a dark green, and then I'm highlighting my leaves and my stem with just a little bit of a brighter, much more limey shade of green. So then as they get closer to the middle, there's going to be one little bit of milkweed, one little branch with a leaf, and then the little blossom that is going to be significantly larger than the rest. This one is closer to the camera. This one is the foreground. This is the milkweed that the 3D butterfly sits on. So that one, as you can see, is significantly larger than the first one that I painted. So there's kind of like, there's these levels. So then afterwards, with some diluted white paint, I just went through and I added the little veins on my larger milkweed, and I added some of the main veins on the smaller ones, but just kind of added a little bit more of that texture on all of my leaves just to kind of brighten those up some. And then a little bit of pink as well. So just a very touch of pink on some of them, because milkweed has, on some of their veins, they have a little bit of the pink that is the same as the flowers. So then with light pink, I'm going to be starting out and just kind of creating the background of my flowers. And then with a darker pink, I added the little details of the individual blossoms, so little five-fingered little things going all over that little bloom, that little clump of flowers, and then add some highlights on each of them with some white paint. So the little tips of all of those little petals need some white paint. So it's basically a whole bunch of little dots on there. So then I'm going to take, and I'm going to be making my larger milkweed, that larger bloom. So when you're doing this one, make it a little bit less circular and a little bit less perfect. You kind of wanted to make it a little bit more detailed too. And so then just go through with your flowers, same basic process, pink background, dark pink, and then light pink, or dark pink and then white. Like I said, I didn't have much time for this. I probably would have gone through and done much more details on these flowers if I had the time that I wished I would have had, but that's just how the cookie crumbles sometimes. And then adding the little white inside each of those. I am happy with it though. I mean, I'm not like saying it's awful. I'm just, it could have been better if you ask me. I'm gonna just go through and add all of those details on there. And then this is kind of the part that's fun. Doing this, the milkweed background was kind of the part that I was like, oh, I don't want to do this. But painting all of these butterflies is the part that I really wanted to do, the part I was a little bit excited to do. And so then go through and add all of your little butterfly wing backgrounds with orange paint. Orange paint, my orange paint, I don't know about your orange paint, but it's not very pigmented. So I think I did at least two or three coats of just orange paint to kind of get it to that orange color that I was hoping for. And then after you have it so that all of your butterflies are there, go through and add a little bit of red, right, kind of just to add some color difference and some color variety in your orange, so it's not just flat orange. You do want to add some brightness and some darkness and some different hues. And plus, if you have any of your butterflies where their wings, you see the front one and the back one, and they're overlapped, adding that red to sort of differentiate between the two sides is really going to help. And then with black paint, I'm going to go through and do all of the major lines on my butterflies. So the major lines between the wings, and then adding the bodies. I'm not doing any of those really fine little lines. I will go back through after this and get those in there, but I want to start and just kind of get the bigger lines in place just so that I know where they are, and it makes the butterflies so much easier to see because they have that nice bright dark outline on them, or intense dark outline. It's not bright, but it just makes them a lot easier to see where they are. So just go through and add all of that. I also added their little antennas at this point, but don't worry about doing all of the little finer veining on their wings that I will get back to in a moment. So just go through with all of these. And when you're doing this, you know, you can kind of get lots. I mean, if you just look up butterflies, you could definitely switch up what kind of butterfly. You don't actually have to just do all monarchs. You could give them all sorts of things. But because it was all milkweed, and monarchs and milkweed go hand in hand, I figured I would just stick with those. And plus, I know that where I live, there's always a time of year when all of a sudden you see all kinds of monarchs in one area and as they're migrating. And that is an amazing thing to experience if you've never seen that before. Definitely look up videos of monarch migration, because it is just amazing. And this is actually what it looks like. It just looks like a whole swarm of butterflies all over the place. So that is an amazing thing to see. And that's kind of what I was going for here. And so then just got all of those in there. And then, like I said, go through with those thinner lines and those finer lines and add the little details on your wings. When you're doing this, I would highly recommend that you dilute your black paint a little bit, just so that it makes those thin lines a little bit easier. And it just is going to go over a lot smoother. If you try to use full strength paint or like a heavier body paint, it's really difficult to get thin lines, and it just isn't going to go over quite as well. So just make sure that your lines are very thin, and to do that, ever so slightly dilute your paint. Plus, when you're painting with acrylic paint on top of acrylic paint, especially something that's like black, that's really, really pigmented, you can dilute it and you're not going to really lose any color payoff. It's just going to make it a little thinner. So don't dilute it a lot, but just a little bit. Just make it a little bit easier to work with. And I'm almost done with all of these. And as you're working with them, you can tell that you kind of get the idea of where all of the where the veins in the leaves are. Oh my goodness, in the wings. I keep thinking of these guys as flowers, and they're not. So then after you have all of that done, go through and in all of those thicker black lines, so basically the ones that we did in the first step of the black outlining, you're just going to go and add white dots in them. Try to definitely leave some of that black outline there, but just feather them out with those little white dots. Monarchs are covered in little white polka dots in their black, so just make sure that you add those, because that's definitely a key factor in your butterfly, even over their body. And then apply another layer of matte gel top coat over the entire mural. I am using one that does not have a tacky layer, and that I definitely think is beneficial. After you have that on there, I'm going to be painting some glossy gel top coat over just the butterflies, because I wanted those to be shiny, and plus that's going to make your black paint really, really stand out and make these butterflies look like they're almost three-dimensional, even though they are not. So it's just going to make them really stand out. So here's the finished mural after it has that really big 3D butterfly on that, which I said, well, I will upload the tutorial for him in the next video, which will be tomorrow. So if you are looking for that guy, I will definitely have that one available, and I'll put a link in the description box below. So check that out, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!